The 48 Laws of Power by Robert Greene. Law number 36, disdain things you cannot have. By acknowledging a petty problem, you give it existence and credibility. The more attention you pay an enemy, the stronger you make him, and a small mistake is often made worse and more visible when you try to fix it. It is sometimes best to leave things alone. If there is something you want but cannot have, show contempt for it. The less interest you reveal, the more superior you seem. In the year 1527, King Henry VIII of England decided he had to find a way to get rid of his wife, Catherine of Aragon. Catherine had failed to produce a son, a male heir who would ensure the continuance of his dynasty, and Henry thought he knew why. He had read in the Bible the passage, "And if a man shall take his brother's wife, it is an unclean thing. He hath uncovered his brother's nakedness. They shall be childless." Before marrying Henry, Catherine had married his older brother Arthur, but Arthur had died 5 months later. Henry had waited an appropriate time, then had married his brother's widow. Catherine was the daughter of King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella of Spain, and by marrying her, he had kept alive a valuable alliance. Now, however, Catherine had to assure him that her brief marriage with Arthur had never been consummated, otherwise Henry would see their marriage as null and void. Catherine insisted that she had remained a virgin through her marriage to Arthur, and Pope Clement XII supported her by giving his blessing to the union, which he could not have done had he considered it incestuous. The king, convinced that she was lying and fearing God had punished them for their forbidden relationship, Henry applied to the Vatican, but Pope Clement would never annul the marriage, and so Henry simply started his own church, putting himself at the top and annulling his marriage that way. The Pope was furious and kept threatening the king with excommunication from the Catholic Church. But King Henry simply ignored him and his now banished from the court ex-wife completely. When you pay attention to a person, the two of you become partners of sorts, each moving in step to the actions and reactions of the other. In the process, you lose your initiative. It is a dynamic of all interactions. By acknowledging other people, even if only to fight with them, you open yourself to their influence. Had Henry locked horns with Catherine, he would have found himself mired in endless arguments that would have weakened his resolve and eventually worn him down. Henry would have none of this. He played a devastating power game, total disdain. By ignoring people, you cancel them out. This unsettles and infuriates them, but since they have no dealings with you, there's nothing they can do. Man, kick him, he'll forgive you. Flatter him, he may or may not see through you, but ignore him and he will hate you. Idris Shah, Caravan of Dreams. There's essentially two strategies to execute. The sour grapes approach. If there is something you want but you realize you cannot have it, the first thing you can do is draw attention to your disappointment by complaining about it. An infinitely more powerful tactic is to act as if it never really interested you in the first place. And the treating it lightly approach. When you are attacked by an inferior, deflect people's attention by making it clear that the attack is not even registered. Look away or answer sweetly, showing how little the attack concerns you. Similarly, when you yourself have committed a blunder, the best response is often to make less of your mistake by treating it lightly. But as always, be warned, develop the skill of sensing problems when they are still small and taking care of them before they become intractable. Learn to distinguish between the potentially disastrous and the mildly irritating, the nuisance that will quietly go away on its own. In either case, never completely take your eye off it. As long as it is alive, it can smolder and spark into life. And that is it for this law. As always, thanks for watching.